From the edge of Music City, it's time for Music City Roots, live from the Loveless Cafe, featuring authentic music from the roots of American culture. I'm Keith Bilbert. We're broadcasting from the big old barn out behind the Loveless Cafe, where Highway 100 meets the Natchez Trace. We're enjoying wonderful Southern hospitality from the Loveless Cafe. And best of all, we've got some world-class artists ready to perform right here, live on our stage. Over on the web in high-def video at musiccityroots.com, on the air, WRLT, Lightning 100 FM, and here in the Loveless Barn. Welcome to Music City Roots. We're glad to have you here. Right now, Grammy Award-winning, the pride of North Carolina, Mississippi, Alabama, Montana. Wow, it's Jim Lauderdale.
Well, thank you, everybody. Hey, and let's give a big hand to Mr. Keith Bilbury. Well, Keith, I was going to start off with something different tonight, but I had a request for this song I wrote with my friend Frank Dykus.
Ooh, let's hear it.
Hey, girl, we've been friends for so long, and I've always been your shoulder when you cry. Now you're asking how to end your heartache. I'm telling you right now, take my advice. If I were you, then I'd love me forever, and I'd be here in these arms where you belong, and I'd spend my life being happy. If I were you, I'd hold me from now on. There's no point in taking chances. You know you want someone who'll always stay. I've always been here when you needed someone to help you make it through your darkest days. If I were you, then I'd love me forever, and I'd be here in these arms where you belong, and I'd spend my life being happy. If I were you, I'd hold me from now on, and I'd spend my life being happy. If I were you, I'd hold me from now on.
Thank you so much, everybody. Welcome to Music City Roots. How are you doing out there tonight? Well, I'll tell you what, Keith, what a show we have got. And to tell you more about that, let's go to our friend over here in the Griffin Technology chat room, Mr. Craig Havighurst.
Hi, Jim.
Hey, folks.
Thanks a million. Yeah, man, look at those guitars. It's like, there's historic instruments up there behind Jim. So much twang per square inch that they have crept into my chat room. That's all right. I want that one. It's good stuff tonight. Country music from top to bottom. Really excited. We have just been so fortunate to work with Marty and putting this night together. We've got Marty Stuart and the Fabulous Superlatives on stage. Yeah, it's exciting. Oh, and look who's going to join our opening set. We are also on that Blackstone lineup going to hear from Connie Smith and the Sundowners. Ready to go. Jim, let's introduce this first fella.
Well, I'll tell you what. For fans of country guitar picking It seems like our first artist tonight has been in the Nashville scene since the days of Castle Recording and the Quonset Hut. But he grew up in Denver, and he honed his style playing in honky-tonks out west. And a friend invited him to Nashville in 1987 for a session. And he came here, and he never left. In 2006, he was named the Americana Music Association's Instrumentalist of the Year. And now he works with Marty Stuart as one of the fabulous Superlatives. And now he's made his first album called V, which comes out on Sugar Hill Records September 13th. Please welcome Nashville's king of guitar twang, Cousin Kenny Vaughn.
Thank you, Jim.
Thank you.
Country music got a hold on me. It bit me in the worst degree. When I was little, heard a fiddle or a steel guitar. I started hopping and a popping like a man from Mars. Country music got a hold on me. It's an affliction that won't let me be. It's a certain fact that's plain to see. Country music got a hold on me. When I turned 18, I joined a hillbilly band. Rocked every joint from Maine to Alabama. Now people, they come on from miles around. Wanna hear me play the country sound. Country music made me what I am. I'ma take a big guitar man. When I'm rocking and rolling, I'm a sight to see. Country music got a hold on me. But I love my girl. My hillbilly princess really set my heart a whirl. But she meaner than the devil. When I gotta go away, got another show to play. Country music got a hold of my soul. I can't stop now, Lord, I'm on a roll. One thing in life was a guarantee. Country music got a hold on me. Coming unglued, just falling apart. Every night in dreams, I know I'm gonna find you waiting for me. Stay out of my mind. If it's plain to everybody that you meant the world to me, they told me you were bad. I was too blind to see. You had me wrapped around your finger, was your little puppet toy. Were my queen, I'm winning, cause was your lover boy. Stay out of my dreams, stay out of my heart. I'm a coming on blue, just a falling apart. If it's not in dreams, I know I'm gonna find you waiting for me. Stay out of my mind. Thank you. find you there. I drink a pot of coffee, I walk the floor and stare. Some precarious predicament, this awful shape I'm in. Cause when I finally fall asleep, there you are again. Stay out of my dreams, stay out of my heart. I'm a coming unglued, just a falling apart. Every night in dreams, I know I'm a gonna find you waiting for me. Stay out of my mind, you nothing for me. Stay out of my mind.
How about this band, everybody? I'm about the luckiest guitar player in town. You all know Marty Stuart.
That guy right there.
Fabulous Superlatives. Paul Martin on the bass. Apostle Paul Martin.
That's right.
And some Harry Stinson on the drum. I've been working with these fellas for about 10 years. I got a new record coming out on Tuesday on the Sugar Hill label.
What's it called?
It's called Kenny Vaughn V.
Yeah.
My first record. We're having a big party on Tuesday at the Ernest Tubb Record Shop at 8 o'clock. Come on down. Here's a song off that album. To worry about the things I do, the things I do. Money to spare, don't have to care about the things I do. No matter how I try, barely getting by. I'm not the kind of guy to sit and whinge and cry about the things I do, the things I do. But life would be sunny if I made more money for the my wife is getting fed up, I get no relief. Every morning when I get up, I get a lot of grief about the things I do, the things I do. She says I'm wrong, doesn't love my song about the things I do. Tell all about the things I do. I pray to the Lord, heaven up above. I thank Him for my blessings, and I put a lot of love into the things I do, the things I do. No matter the game, I honor His name and all the things I do. I made this record over at Gary Pachosa's studio. I have him to thank for helping me get this thing out. I'd like to get my buddy Chris Scruggs up here to play a little steel. Yeah. One of the greatest right here.
I met a little girl from West Virginia, pretty as a peach, charms a plenty. She's nice like that,
nice like that,
nice like that,
nice like that.
She lets me in on where it's at. She's nice like that. Yeah, we got a little place down Tennessee, keeps the home fires burning hot, wait for me. She's good like that. Working in the garden in a little straw hat, she's good like that. Yeah, she's good looking, she's the one kicking it like Kim Kardashian. She's hot like that,
hot like that,
hot like that,
hot like that.
She blows the lid off the thermostat, she's hot like that. Midnight, breakfast at noon, tea for dinner, wine with the moon. She's crazy like that,
crazy like that,
crazy like that,
crazy like that.
She's skinny as a rail but thinks she's fat. She's crazy like that. Oh, she's crazy, Chris. She can break it, she can hang it on the wall, throw it out the window, run out and catch a football. She's fast like that,
fast like that,
fast like that,
fast like that.
Pitch it from the mound, run and smack it with the bat. She's fast like that. Oh, she-
Thank you, Chris. Chris Scruggs, everybody. All right. Well, the boys and I want to send a song out to our old pal, Miss Carol Lee Cooper from the Grand Ole Opry. This one goes out to Carol Lee. Mississippi, all the way to Biloxi. Well, Carol Lee, you look good to me. Oh, Carol Lee, you looking pretty good to me. Well, in the morning we'll be strolling hand in hand in a warm Gulf breeze. Well, you ruby red lips, smile on your face, a moonlight drive down the Natchez Trace. Carol Lee, come on along with me. Well, in the morning we'll be rolling in the sand down by the sea. You and me, Carol Lee.
shoulder on Highway 49 while I ease it on down that Gulf shoreline. Carolee, come take a ride with me. We'll go down to Mississippi, we can be who we wanna be. All right. My grandfather always used to say, Kenny, you need to close your program with a good spiritual. I'm going to do that right now. A song Marty and I wrote.
Don't leave home without Jesus. Take him everywhere you go. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Don't leave home without Jesus. Anytime you're ready to roll. Maybe your beacon in the middle of the night, the master navigator and the guiding light. Don't leave home without Jesus. Take him everywhere you go. You may forget your keys, you may forget your phone. Forget the second notice on a pass-through loan. Oh, a cold laptop, GPS, checkbook, grocery list, all that mess. But don't you leave home without Jesus. Take him everywhere you go. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Don't leave home without Jesus. Anytime you're ready to roll. Maybe your friend in the darkest hour. Help your homies able with the Holy Ghost power. Don't leave home without Jesus. Take him everywhere you go. Forget the gossip, best forget the lies. Forget the temptation of a wandering eye. Forget about the liquor, forget about the dope. Remember King Jesus is your only hope. Well, don't leave home without Jesus. Take him everywhere you go. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Don't leave home without Jesus. Every time you're ready to roll. The good shepherd, the great I am, Alpha and Omega to the wandering lamb. Don't leave home without Jesus. Take him everywhere you go. Take him everywhere you go. Take him everywhere you go.
Don't leave home. Thank y'all.
Kenny Vaughn, everybody. Kenny, you put the scald on it.
Oh, thank you, brother. Thank you.
Kenny Vaughn, go out and get this great album called V. Mighty fine.
Marty.
Oh, Keith, huh?
Leave it to me to follow an act like that. Thank
exactly.
you.
Exactly. You know, Keith, I'd hate to have to be you right now to
Thank
have
you.
To follow that act. Keith Bilbrey, ladies and gentlemen. I kid, Keith.
That is some good stuff. I'll tell you about some more good stuff.
Yeah.
I was just in Gatlinburg. In fact, drove here from there today. And you know where I went. I went and got me some
white lightning.
I did indeed at the old Smoky Tennessee Moonshine. I'm telling you what, you go to Gatlinburg, you can go see it too. It's right there on the parkway and has been rated one of the top 10 attractions in Gatlinburg by TripAdvisor. And they got all kinds of neat things to sell you and to show you, and even free samples of their product, if you get what I mean. And a lot of live bluegrass music. It's a wonderful place, and you don't have to go to Gatlinburg to experience it. There are a lot of places around that serve good old-fashioned, original, unaged corn whiskey from Old Smoky Moonshine. They got White Lightning, as Jim so aptly mentioned. Moonshine Cherries, Apple Pie Moonshine, seasonal flavors. Matter of fact, they got some great moonshine going right now. Peach Moonshine, Pineapple Moonshine, and Hunch Punch. That's one of our favorites around here. Old Smoky Moonshine, the first federally licensed distillery in the history of East Tennessee, which if you know the history of East Tennessee, that's pretty amazing. Very first legal moonshine in Tennessee. It's family-owned business. You can find Old Smoky Moonshine in 9 states around the Southeast, including Tennessee, Kentucky, Georgia, South Carolina, and Florida. Available in these cute mason jars. And you might want to check it out. Give some for Christmas, whatever. And remember to shine responsibly. You can go to oldsmokymoonshine.com and find out everything I'm talking about. If you're in the audience tonight, you can try some for yourself. Just tell the bartenders you want a lightning lemonade or an Old Smoky Moonrise. You will not regret it. Please remember to shine responsibly. When you're in Gatlinburg, go by and see them and tell them you appreciate them sponsoring Music City Roots. Some of our artists tonight are staying courtesy of Holiday Inn Express, Nashville Downtown, and the Nashville Convention and Visitors Bureau. Go to the visit musiccity.com to learn more about great things to do, great places to stay when you visit Music City. And now, over in the Griffin Technology chat room, remember, Griffin Technology was founded on Paul Griffin's kitchen table in 1992. Griffin Technology Incorporated today is one of the world's foremost creators of accessories for home, mobile, and personal technology. Craig Heverhurst, look out. Who have you got over there? I know him.
Keith, I'm pretty excited. Ladies and gentlemen, just say hello to Marty Stuart.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Hello, Craig.
Hey.
Nice crowd.
Like I was saying, this is a treat. Feels like a family affair tonight. Get to hear you. And Kenny's been a big part of your band. I mean, a really important part since you put this band together. How did you meet Kenny Vaughn?
I first saw Kenny play on Austin City Limits with somebody. I can't remember who he was playing with, because the minute I saw him, I didn't watch the artist. I watched him the whole time. And I knew he was a guitar star. We bumped into each other downtown. And he was the first person I talked to about putting a band together. And it's been 10 years now. The Superlatives are 10 years old.
Right.
And I love what we've accomplished. I love traveling with Kenny and Paul and Harry. True statesmen, great men. And Kenny Vaughn is a treasure. He is. And so a lot of people ask me where the name Superlatives came from. Do you guys remember Emma's Florist? Remember? That guy always says, Emma's the superlative florist. That's where we got our band name from, the florist.
And you said, that's hillbilly, I need it. How did this differ from the band you'd been touring with prior? Was it, did you go out with a larger group or a more shifting band? How did this differ?
Pretty much throughout the 90s. It was kind of the same configuration, but I knew that, I've been in bands since I was 9 years old. And in every band leader's lifetime, there is that magic cast. And I figure when I'm dead and gone 100 years from now, this band, the Fabulous Superlatives, will be my legacy band. They can play anything, they can sing anything, they write, and above it all, they're great statesmen, like I said.
Yeah. The current CD has been out just about a year, is Ghost Train, the Studio B sessions. And as with all the records you put out recently, there is a sort of a story behind, just packed into it. In this case, returning to the studio that not only made Nashville famous in the 1960s, but that was really the first place you ever did a session.
When I was 13 years old, Labor Day weekend, I came to Nashville in 1972 and joined Lester Flatt's band, and that was the first place we recorded. And when we put the band together, there really wasn't a home for us other than the Grand Ole Opry, because we were just kind of playing into the weeds. And my assignment to the booking agent was book me as far back into the woods as I can, as you can, and so we don't have to worry about numbers or charts or demographics. We're just going to play music and see where it takes us. And the day that it led me home to traditional country music, and we found a home for it on RFD-TV, and it gave us a place to just stage what I believe in. And then one day we figured out that the most absolute outside and outlaw thing you can do in Nashville, Tennessee these days is play country music. So Studio B was a good place to get all that completely started over.
People may see pictures of studios on TV and see guys in booths behind glass and all cloistered off. Can you just describe for people who have not been over there and taken that tour what this room is? It's just a room.
It was a room that was built for $33,000 or something like that. But I encourage you, as Nashville people, it is one of the towns, it's one of the nation's treasures. And it's hard to explain the feeling that comes into that room when you walk in there. It is truly a music room. So much of country music and American music's legacy has been forged in that room. And it's a bit overpowering and overwhelming when you first walk in there. But it's the best word I found is it's a cathedral. It really is kind of the cathedral of country music. And there's a reverence that goes with that place and a dignity and an integrity. And it really is the arts.
Had you ever made a full album there as a leader before?
Never.
That's pretty remarkable.
Yeah.
So what brought the songs on the record each have their own stories. You co-wrote a song with Johnny Cash right before his death. You have a wonderful song about Porter Wagoner and his passing in his grave. And what was the collection of stuff that you had on the table when you went to the studio? How did you know this was the batch of songs?
Well, it was the bullseye was traditional country music. And the job was, in my mind, to bring some songs that were kind of obscure to the light again into the 21st century. But the real challenge was to write some new songs that would perhaps fit the story and in the big picture of country music. So the best songs are the ones that have been lived through. And songs like you mentioned, Hangman, that I wrote with John, or the song I wrote about Porter, song that Connie and me did called I Run to You, love song. Yeah. You know, those, the best three-minute country songs are the ones that were the writer, the singer, knows from the heart where they're coming from. So that's what Ghost Train was about.
You made it with the Superlatives, so it wasn't like you had a studio band. These were the guys.
And don't need anybody else.
Right. Well, you did bring in Ralph Mooney
Ralph
on steel,
Mooney.
And was that your one sort of outsider guest?
And Gary Carter, Connie's right. player, and Tommy White played steel, and Robbie Turner. But other than that, it was just the Superlatives.
Well, it's an amazing record. Just to wrap up, what's the status of the show? How's it going over there on RFD-TV?
RFD-TV, we start season four in December. Please come out and watch us in December and February.
It's
a
live audience thing.
We need you. Come see it. Enjoy this show, too.
Yeah, you've put this thing together. It's got the sort of that, you got to really tap into the thing that lit you up was seeing these guys on television, that variety show format in the 60s and 70s.
Absolutely. Well, the bottom line is good music and fun. It's integrity music, but at the same time, there's a smile on it.
Sounds great. Well, we can't wait for your set, Marty. Marty Stuart, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for being here. His lovely bride will be up next. But first, I get to introduce you to our friend Allie Sutton, center stage.
Thank you so much, Craig. I don't know about you, but I am loving this chilly weather. Be any chilly that I'm dreaming of. If spring has sprung and fall has fell, the game is on and I'm hungry as hell.
Hello, Vietti, my all natural love. It's Vietti chilly that I'm dreaming of.
Made of family and friends and grandma's hugs, just chilly girl, reminding you to pull the tab and feel the love.
Hello, Vietti, my all-natural love. It's Vietti chilly that I'm dreaming of. And feel the love. Yeah. Thank you very much. Well, friends, we often talk here about how much we appreciate artists who transform traditions into something new. But at the heart of it all is that tradition. And our next guest tonight is the very definition of traditional country music. She was a star in the golden age when hillbilly music was touched with sophistication and romance. She's been one of the highlights of the Grand Ole Opry ever since. She's become one of the boldest and most passionate voices in gospel music. It's more than an honor to welcome her to our Music City Roots stage, Connie Smith and the Sundowners.
Kenny Vaughn, isn't that something? We love Kenny. We love Kenny. This is a song off of my new album that was written by Roy Drusky and Vic McAlpin. Roy had a hit on it years ago. Do this for Keith. Strange to me, somehow it's not the way it used to be. You're doing things you never dared to do before, and I don't believe you love me anymore. Thank you very much. I want to introduce you to my band, the Sundowners. I'm mighty proud to work with them. They're great musicians and they're all my friends. I want you to welcome our lead guitar player. He's my second favorite guitar player in the whole world, if you get my drift. I love him. He's been all over the world with me. He's been with me 14 years now. Would you welcome Mr. Rick Wright, ladies and gentlemen? Oh, yeah. And do any of you see a Marty Stuart show on RFD TV? Hot dog. Well, if you do, then you already know this gentleman, but to everybody else, I got to introduce him to you, and you're going to love him. He's one of the finest steel players. He's keeping the steel guitar alive today. Would you welcome Mr. Gary Carter? What did you say, Rod? He said, just today. I'll tell on you. I want you to meet my drummer. I've loved his drumming from the moment I heard him. I said, that's my drummer. And ultimately, he became a part of our band, and we're mighty proud to have him. Would you welcome Mr. Rick McClure, ladies and gentlemen? And the one with the mouth over here. You've been with me 22 years, and I don't know how that's happened because I fire him every time we do a show.
That's right.
Yeah.
First time you ever heard me play, you fired me.
That's right. I did. First time I ever heard him play. He wasn't even working for me, and I fired
him. Fired
but,
me from another band.
But once in a while, he's nice to me. A few years ago for my birthday, he fired himself. I want you to meet Mr. Rod Hamm, ladies and gentlemen. Marty Stuart and Costas and I wrote this song up in Montana last August, sitting by the creek, watching the deer and the eagles fly. Don't be concerned with how I feel. It's just my heart I can't conceal. It's true. But I'm not blue. You might think I'm falling apart, but I'm just missing all the love we knew. I'm not. Takes getting used to, but I'm not blue. The truth gets hard to say when pride stands in the way. So just let me lie to you. I'm not. Sometimes I just break down when you're not around. It takes getting used to, but I'm not blue. The truth gets hard to say when pride stands in the way. So just let me lie. Thank you very much. When I first came to Nashville, I was so excited. I come on by the invitation of Bill Anderson to actually sing on the Ernest Tubb Record Shop, but he said, if you're ready, I'll pick you up from the hotel and take you to the Grand Ole Opry, and that had been my dream since I was five, is to sing on the Opry, so just to get to go there, it was thrilling. So I got ready, and I was standing out leaning against the side of the hotel, and I saw this convertible pull up, and this good-looking guy hopped out and ran into barbershop. And while I was watching, just standing there waiting for Bill, I saw the traffic guy come over and start writing a ticket because he hadn't put any money in the meter. Before he finished writing the ticket, though, this guy come running out and started sweet-talking him, and first thing you know, he tore up the ticket, let him go. And I didn't think they noticed I was there, but as he got in his car to drive off, he turned around and looked at me and winked. And that was my first meeting with Marty Robbins. And he's one of my very, very all-time favorites. And this is a song that I actually put on a record because Marty had it out. It's a great Gordon Lightfoot song. A ribbon of darkness over me since my true love walked out the door. Tears I never had before. A ribbon of darkness over me. Clouds are gathering o'er my head. They chill the day and hide the sun. Enshroud the night when day is done. A ribbon of darkness over me. Rain is falling on the meadow where once my love and I did lie. Now he is gone from the meadow. A ribbon of darkness over me, where once the world was young as spring, where flowers bloomed and birds did sing. A ribbon of darkness over me. I could be dying to forget you. Oh, how I wish your heart could see how mine just aches and breaks all day. Come on back and take away this ribbon of darkness over me. Please come on back and take away this ribbon of darkness over me. Thank you very much. I always wanted to be a songwriter when I grow up, and I'm still trying. But one time years ago, I was on the road and we were, it wasn't my turn to drive, and I was sitting in the back seat just playing my little baby Martin that I bought because Marty Robbins had one. And I started coming up with this rhythm and I started singing, and I come up with this little ditty I thought, and didn't think much of it, but I sang it for Weldon Myrick, and he got a hold of it and made it the song that I used to audition all my steel players, and obviously Gary passed, but we're going to do it for it. It's called I Come Running. If you ever want somebody to love, if you ever get to feeling blue, if you ever want a little company, then I'll come running to you. Well, it's been so long since I held you tight, but I still dream about you, darling, every night. I don't care who was wrong or who was right. If that's what I've got to do, I'll be around if your new love turns you down, and I'll come running to you. Thank you. Now, when I started talking about writing a song about running, that's the way mine turned out. But then there's the great Dallas Frazier, of whom I've cut 69 of his songs so far. And this is the way running comes out whenever he writes a song. Run away, little tears, our baby's gone. I look at his picture, touch an old souvenir, and then grow weak from holding back these locked up tears. Emotion keeps on working within, breaking down a heart that only he could mend. Run away, little tears, our baby's gone. Run away, little tears, our baby's gone.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Marty's been trying for several years to get me to do a new album. It's been 13 years since I've had one out, and he produced that one 13 years ago. It was called Connie Smith on Warner Brothers. This one's on Sugar Hill Records, and I'm mighty proud to be working with these people. They're great people, and I've enjoyed it a lot. But when Marty and I started looking for songs, he had talked about it for a long time, and I thought, well, I'm not going to find any good songs. And we'd written some, and some that a couple he had recorded. But we got to thinking about it one day, and Dallas Frazier called, and he hadn't written anything for about 30 years. He started writing songs again, and he wrote, as you know, Elvira, Mohair Sam, you know. He wrote Alley Oop. He wrote If My Heart Had Windows, All I Have to Offer You Is Me, little songs like that, and Runaway Little Tears that he just did. But he came over to the house and played us a new song he had written. And it was the very first song that we saved for this album. And I want to do it for you now. It's called What's a Heart Like You Doing in a Fool Like Me? A million times you softly said, don't let him slip away. But pride drowns out what wisdom has to say. Now you're the one who has to pay the cost of broken dreams. What's a heart like you? If only my mistakes could be undone. And once more, hear you whisper, he's the one. Forgive me, heart, my foolish ways have brought you to your knees. What's a heart like you? When you speak, someone to trust and see to all your needs. But here we are, so close and yet estranged as we can be. What's a heart like you doing in a fool like me? Oh, what? If only my mistakes could be undone. And once more, hear you whisper, he's the one. Forgive me, heart, my foolish ways have brought you to your knees. What's a heart like you? Very much.
Connie Smith, everybody.
And my buddy here.
Connie Smith and her fantastic band, the Sundowners. It's awesome, y'all. That's so great. Connie's gonna be back. We're just gonna take a short break. And we'd like to tell you about something really cool that's gonna be happening in Bristol next weekend, Bristol, Tennessee, and Bristol, Virginia. It's called the Bristol Rhythm and Roots Reunion Festival. It's not just a music festival, folks. It's an infectious 3-day music experience bursting with creative passion, electricity, and soul.
Now, I didn't get past infectious. I'm still kind of worried about that. No, that's a good infection, right?
That's right. But it's bursting with passion and electricity and soul. And you can watch a band in Virginia and walk across the street and see a band in Tennessee. It's truly an experience for the whole family. Right, Keith?
Yeah, it's kind of like seeing seven states from Rock
exactly.
City.
Exactly. Exactly. Absolutely.
Now, that is cool. You know, you in that town, you can stand with one foot in Tennessee and one foot in Virginia. It's an amazing thing.
It sure is.
Not to mention that's where the Carter family's from, up in that area.
Oh, that's the birthplace of country music up there in Bristol,
that's right.
Virginia.
Absolutely.
Well, I'll tell you what. I can have one foot here in mediocrity where I'm standing and one foot over here in greatness. Folks, Mr. Keith Bilbury, let's have him say some words about our sponsor.
Here's some words. Pay attention. You're listening to Music City Roots on Nashville's independent Radio Lightning 100, WRLT, Franklin, Nashville 100.1 on your FM dial here in Nashville. Let's give him a big hand. Yeah. Lightning 100. Of course, we're broadcasting live from the big old barn out behind the world-famous Loveless Cafe at the intersection of Highway 100 and the historic Natchez Trace Parkway. When you're in Nashville, you can get breakfast, lunch, and dinner in true Southern comfort style at the Loveless 364 days a year. And as long as it's not Roots Wednesday, you can rent this beautiful barn out for your weddings, concerts, and corporate events. Take a look at lovelesscafe.com for all the information. And before we get back to the music, we'd like to say a very special hello to the listeners on our affiliate WMOT 89.5 FM in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. Thank you for listening, everybody down in the borough. And we'd also like to tell you more about our great partners at Whole Foods Market. These folks seek out the finest natural and organic foods available, maintain the strictest quality standards in the industry, and have an unshakable commitment to sustainable and local agriculture. Now, to add to that the excitement and fun they bring to grocery shopping, and you start to get a sense of what Whole Foods Market's all about. They started with one store in 1980 in Austin, Texas. Today, they're the world's third leader in natural and organic foods with more than 300 stores in North America and the United Kingdom, including four stores in the great state of Tennessee. Now, this Tuesday, we'll be out at the Franklin location on McEwen Drive broadcasting another Music City Roots free lunchtime concert with one of the artists on next week's show, Thrift Store Cowboys. Lunch at a free show? What a great way to spend your lunch break. And to make it even better, Whole Foods Market will be giving away three pairs of tickets to next week's show. Again, please show your support to our good friends at Whole Foods Markets. Tell them thanks for supporting the authentic music of Music City Roots. We'd also like to thank our friends at the Nashville Scene. If you want to know what's happening in and around Music City, well, that's the place to go. Look for a fresh copy at your local newsstand every Thursday or just visit NashvilleScene.com. Griffin Technologies, proud to be a part of Music City Roots and privileged to make the gear you need to power, play, protect, create, and connect to the music that means the most to you. Craig is over in the Griffin Technology Center.
Yeah, and you know, they're right here in Nashville. Nobody
yes,
actually
talks
are.
About
we
that.
They're a
Nashville
the
plant,
company.
Didn't we?
Nashville
great.
Employees, as we love it.
Yes.
Well, yes, I'm over here, and we get to talk to Kenny Vaughn. Yeah. Say hey to Kenny.
Hey.
I'm not sure he's the most superlative of the fabulous superlatives, but he's the guitar player, and he's
the guitar player.
Fabulous at that. Great to see you, and congratulations on the album.
Thank you, Craig.
It's called V for Victory, or Viceroy, or Vaughn. Yeah. Before I ask you about the record, I'd like to hear a little bit about you getting settled in Nashville. When you first came, what was going on? How did you look for work? What drew you in that made you want to stay?
Well, I just kept getting work, and I didn't want to leave because I kept getting work. So, you know, it was nice.
Had you'd been out in Denver and...
Yeah, you know, living the life of a club musician, doing a few sessions here and there, and, not much going on in Denver.
But to have that studio infrastructure, country music going great guns...
Oh, man, it was unbelievable, you know.
Do you have a memory of a particular session that was maybe with a, you know, kind of somebody who maybe you thought I'd never see myself making... music with this guy?
Well, certainly Patti Loveless, when I started recording with her, when her voice came through my headphones, you know, and I'm looking at her through the window, and there she is singing, and it's like, wow.
Yeah.
This is good.
Nice.
Yeah, it was great.
Well, you've been on so many stages with people when we've seen you, and as we said, you won the Americana Instrumentalist of the Year for your work with Lucinda Williams over the years, and Arby Morris, and all these great artists. And so now you've got a place in a band for the last 10 years with Marty.
Yeah,
and,
great.
Just tell us a few minutes about what this your role in this group has been like.
Well, it's just fabulous being with these guys. Like the name says, we have so many songs that we do, and Marty's so good about keeping it fresh. He's always bringing new songs in that he's written. A lot of people remark that we sound like more than four people up there, you know.
All right.
And we're always rehearsing on the bus, talking about music, listening to music, working on music. You know, sometimes we'll write songs while we're out there on the road.
Yeah.
It's great. I mean, you know, it's fun to be out with a bunch of music lovers.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, it's great.
Well then, how did the idea of your record come together? How long had you been thinking about this?
Well, since I was a little kid. Now, we have a merch table, and after every show, we sign autographs and sell CDs and, you know, books and stuff. And people have always asked, when are you gonna make a CD, man? You know, when can I buy a CD? So I've been thinking about it for a while, and Gary Pachosa really made it possible for me to do it.
Our friend Gary from Sugar Hill Records.
That's right, yeah.
And he has a great studio over there in the 12 South neighborhood.
Yeah, his engineer, Brandon Bell, co-produced it with me.
Right.
My wife, Carmela, helped out, so.
How did you kind of figure out what the configuration was going to be, and where did the songs come from, most
of
all?
Well, the songs, I've been collecting those for some time. Marty always features the band on stage. All of us sing a song in the show, and a lot of those songs came from, you know, performing them on stage with Marty.
Okay.
So I've had some of them for quite some time.
And you wrote most of that, or all that material?
Yeah, I wrote them all. Marty helped, he co-wrote two of them with me.
Was the idea of being that lead singer, when I got the record, I thought it could easily be an all-guitar instrumental record. I've seen you sing, but never seen you like front a show. Was the idea of singing your way through this record remotely, was that obvious you wanted to do that?
Well, I've always had bands that where I was the lead singer, you know, since I was a kid, so it wasn't too unusual.
Okay.
Yeah. It was fun.
Sounded good. Let's see, I had one more question. Just went, boom. Anything that you're going to be doing with you as a front man, you're playing every Monday night, or you've been playing Monday nights at the Tap Room, which is great, up in our neighborhood.
Yeah,
and fronting a little blues trio.
Yeah.
And that's to be recommended to anybody in Nashville.
Yeah, I have several bands I play with. They're all trios, and I'm going to be playing some gigs this fall with those guys.
All right.
We're playing at the Americana convention. I'm playing with John Radford and Rich Brinsfield playing bass.
Yeah. And you are able to keep some other projects kind of going and cooking on the side.
Oh, yeah, all the time. I've been playing with Charles Treadway, some, the organ player. He and I are going to do some more gigs coming up pretty soon.
Cool. Oh, I remember now my question. You kept the record pretty straight up country music, which is interesting. You did not.
Well, I wanted to go with what Marty's doing, and I wanted to be able to sell CDs to the people that are coming through his line there, and I didn't want to alienate him by doing something that's too far outside of what they're used to seeing me do, you know.
Right. But you can get far out.
Well, a little bit.
Folks, please say thank you to Kenny Vaughn one more time. And
thank you, Greg.
We're going to get back to Connie Smith here, and we're just taking some breaks here. You live in a chance to talk to these folks and let the artist take a breather. So thanks a lot, Kenny.
Kenny always gets far out. I can't imagine he didn't just a little bit. Well, you may have heard Nissan's joined us as an official partner of Music City Roots, and we're proud and excited to have him with us. And you may have heard that they're introducing an all-new, totally electric, no-gas Nissan Leaf, and it's pretty doggone amazing. If you haven't test-driven one of these babies, believe me, take the time to stop by your local dealer and take one for a spin. And it will change everything you've ever thought about an electric car. Truly an awesome piece of innovation. We're real proud to have Nissan on board with us, and we sure hope you'll take the time to visit them on Facebook. Type in Nissan Leaf or just Nissan. Whether you test drive a Leaf or just drop them a message on Facebook, be sure to tell them you're a fan of Music City Roots, and thanks for supporting authentic music and a healthy planet. And Jim, it's easy. Did you know that? It's easy to find, Jim. It's easy to find. Stay with me. It's easy to find a spot to charge your Nissan Leaf. Did you know that? Well, yeah. There's even a couple of electric vehicle charging stations right out here in the parking lot. Did you know that, Jim? Yeah, they're out there. We applaud Nissan. We proudly join them in hopes of a greener planet. And Jim, one other thing. It's time for you to introduce you-know-who again, you lucky dog.
Oh, yes. Folks, without any further ado, let's bring out the great Connie Smith and the Sundowners.
Thank you, Jim. Are you lonely, just like me? Don't you wish sometimes that love could be what it used to be? Does your heart ache, just like mine? Don't you somehow that we could just go back in time? That makes two of us. That makes two of us. Don't you think it's time to let the healing start? If you title of that song is That Makes Two of Us, and it was written by Costas, Patty Loveless, and her husband, Emery Gordy, and it's one of my favorites on the record. And when we get to picking songs for a show, my band always suggests, let's do this one, because it's so much fun to play and sing. So we're going to do it for you. Hope you feel the same. Next song is a song that I wrote with Curtis Wright, and we wrote it about my husband. It's a true story. You're fired. I thought you and I'd be friends forever, and friends were all that we would ever be. I felt safe enough to share my heart with you, and now you wanna share your life with me. I had thought that this would ever happen. I never would have looked into your eyes before I give an answer to your question. There's one thing that you must realize. I'm looking for a reason not to love you. Trying hard to find a place to hide. Running in the opposite direction. Determined not to let your love inside. Doing all I can to convince me. Keeping my own heart out of the way. Looking for a reason not to love you. While I keep falling deeper every day. I just couldn't take another heartbreak. That's why I'm afraid to feel the way I feel. I promised me next time would be the last time. So promise me this time that it's for real. 'Cause I'm looking for a reason not to love you. Trying hard to find a place to hide. Oh, I'm running in the opposite direction. Determined not to let your love inside. Doing all I can to convince me. Keeping my own heart out of the way. Looking for a reason not to love you. While I keep falling deeper every day. Oh, I'm looking for a reason not to love you. But I keep falling deeper every day. Thank you. Thank you very much. How about another hand for the Sundowners? Rick Wright, Gary Carter, Rick McClure, and Rod Ham. When you found somebody new, I thought I never would forget you. Then I never could. But time has taken all the pains away. Until now, I'm down to hurting once a day. Once a day. All day long. From dusk till dawn, the only time I wish you weren't. I'm so glad that I'm not like a girl I knew one time. She lost the one she loved, then slowly lost her mind. She sat around and cried her life away. Well, lucky me, I'm only crying once a day. Once a day, all day long, and once a night, from dusk till dawn, the only time I wish you weren't born is once a day, every day, all day long, once a thank you very much. I want to do you a song I can always introduce it as the story of my life. God's been so good to me. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. But now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. 'Tis grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears appear. Oh, the hour I first the sun. God bless you. Thank you very much.
Connie Smith, come on out and do another one.
It's an old Hank Williams song. If you know it, you can sing along. When I get to glory, I'm gonna sing, sing, sing. Savior's name. When I get the glory, I'm gonna sing, sing, sing. Now in this life of sorrow, I've seen trouble and woe. When I get the glory, I'll see no more. 'Cause I know my prayers have not been in vain. When I get the glory, I'm gonna sing, sing, sing. Oh, when I get the glory, I'm gonna sing.
Keith, I'll tell you what, it just don't get much better than that, does
Man.
It?
Man, can we go home now?
No, we can't.
No, we can't. We still got a lot of show to come.
No, we can't because, folks, I want to introduce you to the man who puts the brie back into Keith Bilbrey, Mr. Keith Bilbrey.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jim Lauderdale. You know, his middle name is Fort. Did you know that? Jim Fort Lauderdale. Well, never mind. Folks, let's talk for a minute about some things the Nature Conservancy has given Tennessee over the last 30 years. Some things have given me and some things they've given you. Now, conserve means to save, right? It means to take care of and to protect. And that's just what the Nature Conservancy does. It saves the beautiful natural resources in Tennessee and beyond. Clean water for people and for livestock. Clean rivers for fish and freshwater mussels. Lush forests for wildlife and fresh air. Nearly 10,000 caves housing millions of bats in our state. That's what our friends at the Nature Conservancy work so hard to preserve for us in Tennessee, for our kids and for our grandkids. Yes? Oh, I'll get to that. I promise I will, Jim. Okay. All right. Just one more line and I'm going to get to it. So if you hike or hunt or fish, or just try to get the announcer's attention, like Jim Lauderdale. You just love our beautiful, healthy, green state of Tennessee, from Memphis to Mountain City. Well, the Nature Conservancy is working for you and could use your support. Now, what Jim was wanting me to mention, if you want to know more about the Nature Conservancy, they have a table right over there. You can go and sign up this very night to become a member. You can visit nature.org Tennessee, or if you're in the audience tonight, there's information, and you can get a Nature Conservancy membership at the special Music City Roots yearly rate of just $10. Now, if that weren't enough, you can get a free T-shirt with that easy $10 membership in the lobby tonight. And if that's not enough, you can get Jim Lauderdale's brand new album, Reason and Rhyme, over at the table. They're selling those, and if you buy one, a portion goes to our friends at the Nature Conservancy. So check it out. It's a great album. It's a great organization. It's a win-win situation. We'd like to give a shout-out to our friends at Digitech, the official office equipment provider here at Music City Roots. Take a look at those beautiful programs for just a sample of their quality. You can find them at DigitechLLC.com. Right now, Craig Haverhurst, you lucky dog, you.
I tell you, I don't think I'm going to have any trouble
Griffin
getting a
Technologies.
Round of applause for Connie Smith.
Yeah!
One more time.
Thank you.
Oh, that was so good. Where to begin? I guess I'd love to ask you if you and Marty get to do shows as a double bill very often, and what usually leads to that?
Well, we get to do them every now and then. Not as much as we'd like. So many times we pull out the driveway about midnight and he goes one way and I go the other. Right. But we love it when we meet in the middle, and it usually leads to us going home together.
I want to say congrats on being the artist in residence over at the Country Music Hall of Fame.
Thank you very much.
That
it's
is
been
an
a honor
reserved for few people. And how's it been going? Have you done some shows yet? And then I think you've got one coming up Monday night?
We've done two. We've got one more to go. That'll be this Monday night, yes.
Right. How did you think through this opportunity? What did you want to make of it?
Well, first of all, it was such an honor because I've been to so many different functions there at the Hall of Fame, and they've always just been so special. And I wanted mine to be special. And it has been special. The guests that I've had, I had the first night, it was me and the steel guitar, and it was had Weldon Myrick, who played on all of my records for years and years and set the standard for the steel players on my records. And then we had Robbie Turner, who's a great steel player, worked with Waylon Jennings for years, and he's been on my records as well. And Robbie was there, and then Gary Carter that played with us tonight, you could see his talent, and it's great to see that he's continuing what Weldon started and others have started. So I wanted the people to know not only, you know, how much that the steel guitar influenced my records, but how much my records influenced the steel guitar players throughout the land. And then the second one was about the songs, and we did songs because I had the new record coming out the day after that show. We did songs like that I had written with Marty and Costas. We did songs that I'd written with Dallas Frazier, or songs that Dallas had written for the record, and songs that Marty and I had written, and even did the first song I ever wrote before I came to town. So we had a wonderful time. The people were great. Can't wait. This one coming up Monday will be about the girls. The girls that have influenced me, and hopefully the girls I've influenced.
For sure. Speaking of the new record, I just thought I'd bring along a copy because I popped it in the car on the way here, and it's wonderful. Long Line of Heartaches on Sugar Hill. And like you said on stage, first time in a while.
It is, but what I really wanted it to be was a continuation. Just like at the Hall of Fame, my part now at 70 years old is to teach, you know, and to carry on what I was blessed with in the 60s and to show them it's still alive and well. And in this record is, I wanted it to be just as if when I quit recording to stay home with my kids, that I could pick up and start over because my musical tastes haven't changed. And
right.
And we were able to do that with the help of Marty Stuart helping me write songs and produce the record and play guitar on it, and Mick Connolly doing the engineering and all the great musicians that were on it. My band is on it, as well as Paul, one of the fabulous Superlatives, Paul Martin, is on it. So we had some great times.
And it looked from the pictures like you were in Studio B as well.
Absolutely.
At RCA Studio
and I
B.
recorded most of my hit records at Studio B.
Right, so that was like going back home. And it hasn't changed. I mean, the beauty of that room is you walk in there and set the guitars up, and it could be 30 years ago.
Yeah, and the main thing is the sound hasn't changed. It's still there to, it's just, that sound is still there just to love on you while you're singing.
So Marty's was the producer.
Yes. And
now, what does that really mean? What can he do to make you with a bunch of great musicians in that room better?
Everything Marty puts his hand to gets better, because he's a genius at what he does, and he has so much heart, and he has the talent, he has the wisdom, he has the tradition, he has all of it. As I said, he and I co-wrote 5 of the songs on the album. He helped me pick the other songs. We just walked it through together from start to finish. He played rhythm guitar, but he also played different other guitar parts that he felt like Rick Wright, him and Rick just danced all the way through the record with each other. It was everything that Marty did. I mean, from all the way through, you know, Marty he's great.
You talk in your bio on this record about feeling fortunate to start your career in the 1960s, in an age of country music, yeah. A particular time. What was it about that time that you feel matched what you did well, and why did you feel lucky?
Well, I think when I came to Nashville in 64, they said there was room for 1 million, but only 1 of each. You had to be your own individual self. You had to find out who you were and bring yourself to the table, because if you sounded like anybody else, then you didn't get anywhere. And in the difference of today, where someone has a record, the next record comes out and sounds like it. It was a very individualistic thing, and I was blessed to be in a time like that where I could be who I was and be accepted. I mean, you go from Waylon Jennings to Jerry Reed to Hank Snow to Eddie Arnold to, you know, to Dottie West to, you know, to Kitty Wells to Loretta Lynn, you know, to Porter Wagoner, and, you know, so many genres, so many different voices that came out, and also the musicians in that day, 2 notes into the song, you knew. It's kind of, we picked our own little team of people to work with, and you knew who the singer was before the singer said a word.
And I really wanted to ask you about your voice. Is one that is, you know, is big, and you get to really push a lot into it, and it would sound more like some of the pop singers of that time, instead of the sound of, say, a Kitty Wells voice was not hitting the big notes, the long arcs, the really full female, full-throated voice. Was that something that you felt like you were doing, that there were any models in country music women? I mean, it wasn't Gene Shepherd's sound. It wasn't Kitty Wells' sound. And was that something you felt was new?
I never thought about it, except that I listened to all kinds of music growing up, and I picked what I liked. The thing that I picked from Gene Shepherd is her voice was so clear, her words, you could hear every word, she was right on pitch, and she was one of the models that I modeled after, because I thought, this is so great, because when she sang, it was so out front, and it was there. Jimmy C. Newman had all the curls and I love that.
That's true.
And then, of course, George Jones, you can't beat that, and there's just so many that I never really patterned after any one, but I'm sure I picked up things that I liked from each one and used it.
Sure. Well, any final words about this record, now that it's out and out there, and you've gotten to hear some feedback on these songs and the performances of these songs? I mean, it must feel terrific to have it out there.
It's very exciting. As I said earlier, it's my first one in 13 years. Yeah. And once I got done, I think, why did I wait so long? But I've loved it. It was a joy to make, to work with Marty and Mick Connolly and all the band. And especially to have the Sundowners on the record, that was a big thrill for me. And I just hope the people that get it will enjoy it as much as we enjoyed putting it together.
I think they will. It's back there for sale, and I'm enjoying it myself. Thank you, Connie
Thank
Smith.
You,
we appreciate seeing you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
All right.
Jim Lauderdale.
Folks, it was through the good graces of our next guest that this evening of superior country music came together. He's truly one of the greatest forces in American modern music. I'll tell you what, he's a huge hero of mine. Please welcome Marty Stuart and his fabulous Superlatives.
Thank you, Jim.
Stop the world and let me off. I'm tired of going around and around. Well, I play the game of a love and loss. So stop the world and let me off. My dreams have shattered, don't you see? For you no longer care for me.
Lord, and let me on. I'm tired of going around and around. Well, I play the game of love and law. So stop the world and let me on.
How about a hand for Miss Connie Smith and the Sundowners? How about a hand for Cousin Kenny Vaughn? And Jim Lauderdale. I love Jim Lauderdale. It's his world. We're just living in it. Somebody say, oh!
Well, I'm branded wherever I go, trying out to run a bad story everybody seems to know. Might as well be wearing a ball and chain, 'cause everywhere I travel see my picture with a number by my name. Spent some time in San Francisco, locked up for vagrancy. Busted out a time or two, took a run at getting free. They put me back in the jailhouse, finished serving my time. Turned me loose and the man said, oh, dog, it's ball and chain, 'cause everywhere I travel see my picture with a number by my name. Well, the trouble with the truth always comes around, seems to be there waiting in every town. Well, I'm guilty of crime, trying to get back home. Don't want to bother nobody, just want to be left alone. But I'm branded wherever I go, trying everybody seems to know. Might as well be wearing a ball and chain, 'cause everywhere I travel see my picture with a number by my name. Thank you.
right so far? Somebody say, well, 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 there was a time, hey, I could drink my cares away and drown out all of the heartaches that hurt me night and day. When the thought of you came crashing through, well, I'd have one more. But now the whiskey ain't working anymore. I need the one good honky-tonk angel to turn my life around. That's a reason enough for me to lay this old bottle down. Cause the whiskey ain't working anymore.
Well, I was coming round, round, round. In my mind, peace I'd find when they start to pour. But now the whiskey, it ain't working anymore. Everybody say, well, I need one good honky tonk angel to turn. Sing it for us, come on. Well,
cause
well,
the
whiskey ain't working anymore. The whiskey, it ain't working this place. I hadn't been out here since they built the barn. We need to come back more often. This is nice. This is nice. This is the first $2, 3, or 4, or 5 million barn in this part of town I've ever seen. That's nice, man. Goes good with those biscuits over at that place over there. That's good. Yeah, this is my friend Kennerly. There's a girl trying to steal my heart, and I'm tempted. Even though she could tear it apart, I'm tempted. And her eyes, there's mystery every time she smiles at me. Well, I know how it could be, and I'm tempted. Each time she looks my way, I'm tempted. Just a little more every day, I'm tempted. It's so hard to resist the thought. I can't deny that I'm tempted. Hey. tempted. Tempted and tried, deep down inside, I can't deny that I'm tempted. Tempted and tried, deep down inside, I can't deny that I'm tempted. I am tempted. I am tempted. I am tempted.
You can't fake a goosebump, can you? You cannot. Did you feel that?
I did feel that.
I don't know. Did you feel it?
Handsome? Yes, absolutely.
It was that West Nashville feeling, you know?
Yeah.
No, it's bigger than that. I heard Connie out here talking about Marty Robbins. And just for a split second on that last course, it sounded like Marty Robbins and his band came marching across the stage. The spirit of Marty Robbins. Y'all remember Marty Robbins, of course.
Yeah.
It was big. One of the greatest country singers. My mama named me after Marty Robbins, but can't nobody sing like him. But since that feeling came across, we ought to try to do a Marty Robbins song.
All right.
It'll be interesting since we don't know any.
Come on.
Oh. We'll come up with something. This could really suck. If it does, it don't matter. We done got your money. Okay, what key? What key?
D.
As in?
Lauderdale.
What have we done here? The spirit of Marty Robbins and the boys.
I laughed it off when you left. Said you'd come back again. Don't we all have the right to be wrong? Now and then you played it smart, broke my heart, said you'd be mine again. Don't we all have the right to be wrong now and then? Guess I wasn't so smart after all.
Get it.
If you're looking for love, there's only two ways to fall. I left it all when you left. Said you'd come back again. Don't we all have the right to be wrong now and then? Don't we all have the right to be wrong now and then? We'll be right back.
back.
Marty Stuart and his fabulous Superlatives. I love you. Marty Stuart and his fabulous Superlatives. Don't go away, because they're just taking a short break. And they're going to be right back after these fine words from Mr. Keith Bilbrey.
Now catch your breath while I expand mine, right? Okay. Well, you're listening to Music City Roots on Nashville Independent Radio, Lightning 100 WRLT, Franklin, Nashville, 100.1 on your FM dial here in Nashville, Tennessee. Are you having a good time tonight? Oh! Well, don't go anywhere, because we got more. Folks, what's your financial institution done for you lately? Well, for the past 5 years, Ascend Federal Credit Union's returned more than $26 million to its members, coupled with low rates on mortgages and auto loans, free electronic services to help you manage your money, and free budget assistance. Ascend just gives you more. Ascend's a nonprofit financial co-op owned and operated by its members. They have a volunteer board of directors that works hard to keep fees low, rates competitive, and keep the credit union moving forward. So, what's your financial institution giving you? Well, there's never been a better time to be a member of Ascend Federal Credit Union. Spread the word. To find out more, visit ascendfcu.org. You can also visit your nearby Ascend Financial Center or call 800-342-3086. Personal financial service that aims higher. Ascend Federal Credit Union, raising possibilities. Ascend's an equal housing lender, federally insured by the NCUA. Membership is limited. And talking about membership, Jim Lauderdale, a member of the original country club. Yes, sir. You got more music for us?
What's that?
You got more music for us?
I think we do.
I think we do.
Let me see, Keith. Let me see if we can...
Check on that.
Fellas, check on that. Can we get you back out for some more? Are all the guys ready to go? Keith, let's stall for just a minute
what,
here.
What, the bathroom door get
been?
Locked on somebody
how you
or something?
Been, my main man?
I've been good. I want to watch you squirm a while. Go ahead.
Keith Bilbrey, ladies and gentlemen. No, I'll tell you what, Keith. I've thought of so many great things for us to talk about, and I can't think of a single one right now.
You forgot every one
Let
of them.
Let me go see how the fellas are doing over here.
Bless his little heart.
Keith.
Do you remember, the first time I met Marty Stuart, he was like 13, 14 years old. And was already a touring member of the Lester Flatt Band.
That's when I first saw him.
They used to come up to the radio station and do the Martha White show. They'd tape several of them at a time. And here was this little old guy with a mandolin. The mandolin's almost bigger than he was.
I first saw him when I was 15, and I went to a big bluegrass show in Atlanta, Georgia.
Uh-huh.
And he was playing with Lester Flatt. I got to see him with Lester several times. And I'll tell you what, he has been a hero of mine ever since.
And then he broke all our hearts. He married Connie Smith.
I know, but Connie we forgive Stewart, him because he's so great. Let's see if we can get him back out here. Marty Stuart and his fabulous Superlatives.
Fabulous Superlatives!
Hello, Mr. Bilbrey.
Hello, Mr. Stuart. How are
nice
you?
Nice to see you.
My soul brother.
That's exactly right. Love it.
Oh, yeah. How's your mom and daddy?
Mom and daddy's doing good. My sister Jennifer's down here. Say hi to my sister Jennifer.
I've been visiting with Jennifer. She's been taking your picture. Did you know that?
Yeah. All right. Well, we all know that September the 11th is coming up, and we know what that means. But the day that follows September the 11th will always stand out to me, too, because that's the day that Johnny Cash passed away. 8 years ago, it seems like it hadn't been no time, but it has been 8 years. And I love that song that Cousin Kenny sang about country music got a hold on me. This is the truth. The first two records I ever owned in my life when I was a kid down in Mississippi was Lester Flatt and Earl Scruggs' Greatest Hits and the fabulous Johnny Cash. And the only two jobs I ever had in my life was Lester Flatt and Johnny Cash, so that worked out pretty good, you know? And that's the music that
set my heart on fire, and I didn't want to go to Los Angeles, I didn't want to go to New York, I wanted to come to Nashville and be a part of country music's family. And so that worked out too. I like it. Connie and I actually wound up living next door to John and June over in Hendersonville, Tennessee, up in Hendersonville, Tennessee from here. And there's not a day that goes by that I don't miss him, especially when we're home. I think when I'm on the road, I can pretend that we're all just out working or something. But when I go home, and you know, even the house is gone now, so there's nothing except just a pile of rocks. But his spirit lives, and he talks to me, and he still inspires me, so that's the kind of thing. That's the kind of man and the legacy he is, you know. But here's the other thing. Between our houses, there's a beautiful piece of ground. And in the 1960s, Roy Orbison had a home there. And a lot of old-time Nashvillians will remember Roy had a tragedy on that piece of ground. His boys were playing with hairspray and cigarette lighter. And it caught the house on fire and burned it down and took the boys' lives. So, of course, he never wanted to live there again. So he sold that property to John. And John made Roy a vow that he would never build anything on that property. He'd always only plant things to bring life back to the property. And his version of that was trees. And it was all fruit trees. He planted pecan trees, apple trees, pear trees, you know, cherry bush, fig bush. It was just a beautiful sanctuary that he set out and raised. And now they're majestic old trees. And after he passed away, me and Connie bought that piece of ground from John Carter and the family. And so today it's still just like he left it, all the trees that are left. And here's the thing. After he passed away, I tried to do what a lot of songwriters around the world did. I tried to write me a song about my old friend to make me feel better. And nothing ever would come, so I just forgot about it. But in the springtime, when the fruit starts coming on those trees, I get a big visit from the crows. And I don't know about you all, but I dearly love crows because they're really weird birds and they dress like Johnny Cash. And that's incredible. So one day I was in the orchard in the spring, and this old crow was hanging around up in one of those trees, and he was just raising cane. You know, I thought, that reminds me of JR. It's what I call John. And so on the inspiration of that old crow, I went home, and the next morning I got up and heaven sent down a song. And so I want to do this for John tonight, my friend and yours. It's called Dark Bird. On a cool September morning in the fall of 2003, a crier from Jerusalem brought the news to me. His words were sharp and dreaded, they made a lonesome sound. They snapped my heart in two like a stick stepped on the ground. Well, I cried and cried and cried at the cutting of the pain, and I quietly said goodbye, so long in Jesus' name. Dark bird, watch you fly. Dark bird, to another sky. I'll bet you were a sight when you hit that cloud of love and flew out the other side. Form of a dove, dark bird, dark bird. Six feet one and a box of steel and a pretty coat of black. Well, I watch the world, watch themselves, watch her final act. I couldn't help but notice when we laid you in the earth. The train went by, headed north, for whatever it is worth. Your voice echoes in the wind, it rumbles through the trees. After you've been everywhere, I guess it's time to leave. Dark bird, watch you fly. Dark bird to another sky. I'll bet you were a sight when you hit that cloud of love and flew out the other side. In the form of a dove, dark. I got. Thank you. Superlatives. Yeah. Has this not been a great night at Music City Roots? It's been a great night. This is kind of your side of town, pal.
That's right, pal.
Yeah, you know all the folks at the Waffle House on the Charlotte Avenue. I do too. Have you enjoyed yourself?
Yes, I've had a good time.
Me too, Harry. Me too. Yes, sir. We will come back. I've noticed some things.
What'd you notice?
Well, first of all, this is a wonderful crowd.
Oh, it's beautiful.
I listen to it on the radio. Jim Lauderdale is just the best, and old Keith Bilbert.
Yes.
But here's the thing. I was up there looking. Nice as this bunch is, I have never in my life seen a crowd of people that need a gospel song any worse than they do.
Well, I think we ought to help them out. What do you think? We're just the men for the job,
ladies and gentlemen.
We're going to do one from the old Bill Monroe songbook. How about, I'm working on a building for my Lord. It goes like this.
I'm working on a building. I'm working on a building. Working on a building for my Lord.
Wait.
Nashville's own Handsome Harry. We were at the warehouse one day rehearsing, and the next thing I knew, this song appeared. And we'd like to leave you with this song, and I especially love this song and what it says and what it means to me. And it is called Heaven. Thank you very much.
Marty Stuart and his fabulous Superlatives. I'll tell you what, let's hear another one if we can get them back out here. Y'all want to come on out here, Marty Stuart.
I'm honored to be here with you tonight. You are such a Nashville treasure. You're a treasure everywhere, but I love the radio show you're doing. Just like Keith Bilber, you're keeping a lot of great things alive and promoting a lot of great things. If it weren't for your show, there wouldn't be a lot of people heard. So thank you very much, Jim Lauderdale.
Thank you, Marty. Marty Stuart and his fabulous Superlatives, everybody.
Can we hear one from the Apostle Paul? Make Apostle Paul feel welcome.
Let's do a train song about the home state of Kentucky.
Sounds good to me, brother.
And call this Bluegrass Express.
Yeah.
Riding the Bluegrass Express. Riding the Bluegrass Express. This train will soon be gone.
Express.
Superlatives.
Marty Stuart and his fabulous Superlatives. Amazing, y'all. Thank you, my brother. Marty Stuart and his fabulous Superlatives. Folks, don't go away, because we're just about to load up for the loveless jam here where anything could happen, you know. And I'll tell you what, let's thank our Blackstone Brewery lineup for this evening. Kenny Vaughn.
Yeah, Kenny!
Connie Smith and the Sundowners. And Marty Stuart and his fabulous Superlatives. Keith.
Oh, yeah. Our Blackstone lineup for next week, Wayne Henderson, Shotgun Party, Todd Grebe, Coal Country, the Everybody Fields, and the Thrift Store Cowboys. It's going to be a great show. Thanks to our sponsors, the Loveless Cafe, Old Smoky Moonshine, Griffin Technology, Nissan, Whole Foods Market, Vietti Chili, Ascend Federal Credit Union, the Nature Conservancy, and it's a great time to thank our world-class sound engineers from Sound Image. Look at them run to get everybody mic'd and plugged in. You'll find these guys on tour with just about anybody who is anybody. With offices from Los Angeles to Nashville, they can help you with anything from a world tour to a sound system in your boardroom or your church. Take a look at sound-image.com. They're a proud sponsor of this final segment. We call it the Loveless Jam. Everybody gets together and has a good time, and I think that's about to happen. Have you had a good time tonight? Yeah. All right. Well, Jim, let's put the icing on this cake. What
let's
do you
do,
say?
Keith. I'll tell you what, Keith. I think this is about one of the best evenings of music I've ever heard
Absolutely.
In my life. I'll tell you. Folks, you know, I usually sing the first part of these jams, but I'll tell you what, we've got royalty here tonight. And I want I want Connie Smith to kick this one off. Connie?
I've got that old time religion. I've got that old time religion. And that is why I'm satisfied. Well, you ask me if I'm happy and if I have that peace within. If I'm worried about tomorrow when I reach my journey's end, I'm satisfied with my Jesus. When he knocks, I'll let him in. He'll go with me through all these.
At their door.
Well, tell me more.
If they sow no seeds of kindness, can the storm clouds ever grow? Well, it won't matter over yonder when I reach that other side. Well, I'll sit down with my Jesus, satisfied.
I'm satisfied.
if I'm happy, if I have sweet peace within, if I'm worried about tomorrow, when I reach my journey's end. Tell me more, Connie.
Well, I'm satisfied,
satisfied
with my Jesus.
With your Jesus.
Oh, when he knocks,
when he knocks,
I let him in.
You gonna let him in.
Cause he'll go with me.
Oh, that's right.
Through all these valleys.
Of Hang Dye Media, executive producers Todd Mayo and John Walker. We'd like to give a big thanks to Wesley Dillard here with his wife Marie tonight. Thanks for keeping the beans counted for MCR. And of course to all our friends at Lightning 100, thanks for being a true voice of independence in Nashville. We're glad you joined us this week for Music City Roots live from the Loveless Cafe. I'm Keith Bilbrey and from the edge of Music City, good night. CDs will be available over here in the back corner. Thank you, Rod.
Hang Dye.